When you talk about the image of Christ, it is important that we no longer ascribe to the European image of Christ. Why? Because the brain is an associating organism. It stores everything as pictures. And because it is associating, if you force feed an African child that Christ is white, because the brain associates, as that child begins to grow, the brain will associate white Christ with white people. And so if white Jesus is God, then white people must also be the gods of humanity. And so guess what? The power in the painting is transferred to the people who resemble that painting. And so it is difficult to pray to a white Jesus and not in some way feel inferior to white people.
Jesus was not born in a manger in central Pennsylvania. He was a man of color. And the fact that we have represented him for centuries, literally as a white man, speaks to the entire history of white supremacy. The image of a white Jesus has been used to justify enslavement, conquest, colonialism, the genocide of indigenous peoples. There are literally millions of human beings whose lives have been snuffed out by people who conquered under the banner of a white God.
People always ask me, why do the black church not get rid of the white Jesus and put a blue black Jesus in place with a nappy head? Because black people would stop coming.
In fact, today, if you were to go to Africa and talk to the children who've been Christianized, they will tell you that their ancestors covenanted with devils, and this is why black people are in the condition they are today. So turn to Christianity, and of course you turn to the oppressor's religion, and then you eat the gruel that they give you, and at the bottom it says Jesus saved you. Of course, you're conditioning that person for another 1,000 years.